Islam. Rise, 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 rise of Islam. Rise. We are stronger together, united as one Ummah. Rise, 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 rise of Islam.
22. Civil War, Battle of Camel. In the last episode, we talked about how during Caliph Ali Radin Tala's first week, he ordered to remove all of Uthman Radin Tala's governors. And this made some of them really mad. One of them was Syria's governor and Uthman Radin Tala's cousin, Muawiyah Radin Tala. His biggest complaint was that Ali Radin Tala wasn't punishing the rioters who destroyed Uthman Radin Tala. So, as a relative, Muawiyah took it as his own responsibility to bring justice for Uthman Radin Tala. Every day at the Mosque of Damascus, Muawiyah displayed Uthman Radin Tala's bloody shirt and the fingers of his wife that was cut off when she tried to save her husband. By showing this to the people of Damascus, Muawiyah Radin Tala convinced many people to join his army and fight against Ali Radin Tala. From the beginning of Caliph Ali Radin Tala's rule, they were both extremely mad at each other and wanted to fight each other. At the same time, the governors of Mecca, Basra, and Yemen also did not like Ali Radin Tala's decision and joined Aisha Radin Tala, hoping that she could bring justice and peace. We need to understand that during Caliph Abu Bakr, Umar, and Uthman Radin Tala's rule, Aisha Radin Tala was a very active public political figure. Because she was the Prophet's wife and the first Caliph Abu Bakr Radin Tala's daughter, everyone respected her greatly. Plus, her nickname was the Mother of the Believers. The people of Basra liked Talha Radin Tala, so Aisha Radin Tala's group decided to go to Basra to get more supporters. In their journey, some of the Prophet's other wives and some other important women also joined the group to get justice for Uthman Radin Tala. In Basra, there were many of the bad Ibn Saba's people who did not like Aisha Radin Tala's group and attacked them. But Aisha Radin Tala's group destroyed them. When the Munafiq, or the fake Muslim, Ibn Saba heard that some of his supporters in Basra were destroyed, he got really mad and convinced Caliph Ali Radin Tala that Aisha Radin Tala wanted to fight with Caliph Ali Radin Tala. But that was a lie! Her goal was to only punish the rioters and the bad people who killed Uthman Radin Tala. Unfortunately, both the fake Muslims and the rioters were pretending to be Caliph Ali Radin Tala's close friends and advisors, and they were able to convince him with the lies. Caliph Ali Radin Tala was now mad at Aisha Radin Tala and decided to go to Kufa since it was close to Basra and got more supporters for his army. There were many, many Sahabas on both sides, and because of that, they did not want to fight each other. Because they knew that as Muslims, they should be united together. Caliph Ali Radin Tala gave very high respect to Aisha Radin Tala and the other Sahabas. And to avoid war between the Muslims, Caliph Ali Radin Tala sent the great commander, Qaqa ibn Amr Radin Tala, to talk with Aisha, Zubair, and Talha Radin Tala. This was done so everybody's misunderstandings would clear up. And after this talk, both sides agreed for peace. Caliph Ali Radin Tala promised them to find and punish the bad people who killed Uthman Radin Tala and met Aisha Radin Tala's group at Basra to unite the Muslim Ummah once again, as what a good Muslim leader would do. But as the peace agreements were finalizing, bad Ibn Saba and his group got scared, because they knew that they would get caught for all of the evil things that they had been doing for years. So, he and his evil group planned to destroy all three leaders, Ali, Zubair, and Talha Radin Tala. But altogether, the bad Ibn Saba had less than 3,000 people, while on the other hand, Ali Radin Tala's group had 20,000 and Aisha Radin Tala's group had 30,000 soldiers. So, Ibn Saba decided to do the most evil act of all, which was to permanently destroy the Muslim Ummah. He made a plan to divide his people so that some of his people were on Caliph Ali Radin Tala's side and the others were on Aisha Radin Tala's side. At night, when everyone was still sleeping, Ibn Saba's people decided to attack both sides. Both sides thought that the other side broke the peace agreement, and both sides became extremely angry and started to destroy each other. Both Caliph Ali Radin Tala and Aisha Radin Tala were extremely confused why the war was happening, and they both tried really hard to stop the war, but no one was listening to them. Aisha Radin Tala came out with her camel trying to tell them to stop, but from far away, her people could not hear her, and instead, they thought that she came out with her camel to encourage them for motivation to fight even more. Soon, the war got so out of control that both sides were not stopping. Then Caliph Ali Radin Tala realized that the only way to stop the war was to stop Aisha Radin Tala's camel. As long as her camel was there, the people got their motivation. So he ordered his men not to hurt Aisha Radin Tala, but to stop her camel instead. And as soon as her camel went down, her supporters scattered off. This was called the Battle of the Camel, which was the first part of the first Muslim civil war. Here, Caliph Ali Radin Tala won, but right away he ran over to see if Aisha Radin Tala was alright and asked her if she was hurt. Alhamdulillah, both of them were safe, but they both felt extremely guilty and couldn't believe what just happened. They were both so ashamed and wished that they were never alive to see this moment in history. Both of them realized that it was the evil people who were behind this biggest tragedy of Islam. Unfortunately, 10,000 Muslim Sahabas died in that battle because the Muslims were not united together and could not figure out who the real enemy was. After the Battle of the Camel was over, Caliph Ali Radin Tala gave Aisha Radin Tala the most highest respect and made sure that she and the other 40 powerful women safely returned to Mecca. Ali Radin Tala's son, Hassan Radin Tala, also helped them on their journey for several miles. This just shows how much respect they had for one another, even though the terrible event happened. In this battle, the famous Talha Radin Tala got badly hurt and later passed away. Ali Radin Tala's cousin Zubair Radin Tala did not want to fight against the Caliph of Islam, Ali Radin Tala, so he left the battleground, but someone else killed him while he was praying. After hearing this news, Caliph Ali Radin Tala's eyes filled with tears and prayed for both of them, as they were always so close before the fake Muslims ruined everything.